All right, so we'll start with the first session of the day, which is on use of custom apps. So we'll have a look at a small presentation, then we'll follow it up with some of the demonstrations of the custom apps that have been built for DHIS2, specifically for the COVID-19 use case, because there were a lot of varied requirements coming from different countries, especially for contact tracing analysis and also generating COVID-19 vaccine certificates, etc., which were not available by default. Hence, there were some enhancements were made as web apps into the system by different use groups based on the requirements they were receiving from the countries they were supporting. So we have a look at some of these examples and take it up. So the learning objectives of the session now, so we'll understand how custom apps can support the tracker implementation. We'll see the contact tracing application, which was developed in collaboration between Sri Lanka and Ministry of Oslo. And we'll see one of the COVID-19 certificate app, which has been developed by His Best in Central Africa for supporting the implementations in their respective countries. So, in the last couple of days, we have seen how these outputs can be made when you're working with your tracker data through event reports, event visualizer, and we also saw data visualizer yesterday where you could generate data through program indicators. But there are instances where these tools do not fit the requirements or cannot be extended any further to meet the requirements. In these cases, we kind of develop custom apps which can be very requirement specific, and given the flexibility the DHIS2 framework offers, these apps could be installed on your current DHIS2 databases or new DHIS2 databases, and they'll start working immediately by taking data from the DHIS2 database, from the tracker and events programs, and then this data can be shown or utilized in a way possible wherever you have custom requirements to fit into. Why these custom apps are advantageous? Because they'll allow you to use all the data which is stored in your database, and you can create your outputs or interfaces based on your requirements. So a lot of his groups do have their own software development teams where there are developers who kind of can extend existing functionalities of DHIS2 through these web applications. There have been some examples where we have custom applications for outputs, custom applications for importing large data sets, custom applications for scorecards. So there are many examples, and there is an app hub for DHIS2 where all these applications are hosted, and the ones which are published on the app hub could be utilized by any country, any implementation, if those the requirements that these custom apps fulfill, if they match a use case, then these can be installed on your DHIS2 instance as well. So this is an example of the COVID-19 certificates. A lot of countries wanted to issue certificates right from their DHIS2 instances where they were managing their data for COVAX. So there are some examples of Republic of Vanuatu where they had custom development done. So within the tracker capture web app, they did an enhancement and they added their vaccination certificate then and there in the app itself. Or this is an example for His Best in Central Africa where they generated a COVID-19 vaccination certificate by searching the or passing the ID of the patient and then or the beneficiary and then generating a certificate for that member. So these were certain use cases which came across during the COVID-19 vaccination program. Then we had examples where COVID-19 relationships were of the key importance, where we wanted to understand the relationships between the contacts, the index cases and the contacts. So a couple of COVID-19 relationship apps were developed. One of them that we'll see today was developed in collaboration with the Ministry of Oslo and Sri Lanka. There was another app which was developed by the Norwegian Institute of Public Health in Norway. They had developed a similar app, the interface which you see now. This one is a bit complicated. It is based on R, so it uses R Shiny as a platform to generate these network diagrams between the index and the contacts. The one which we'll see today is fairly simple. It generates a similar network map, and you can see the index case and the contacts directly through the data which is clicked from the tracker data node. So these apps basically are an extension over the maps feature that we saw yesterday, because when you're seeing the maps feature for relationships, we saw that it only is kind of limited to use of one program. It doesn't work across programs. But then these apps which were built were working across programs. So they were picking data from both the index cases as well as the contact cases from the specific COVID case surveillance program and the contact registration follow up program. So this is the app which we see today, where it shows you the diagram of all index cases and their contacts which have been identified and have been registered in the system. You could see the details of the index case and each of the contacts, and you can even click on the open in tracker capture button to have a look at their record and get more information from them. You could also see, this is a separate app which was also developed by one of his groups that also was based on the COVID-19 relationships. So we kind of see the overall idea is that the requirements were same across his groups of having applications which could help them analyze data by the relationship between the index cases and the contact cases, but there was no standard solution available which could fit the requirements, and from country to country, the requirements differed. Hence, each of the groups who were supporting the countries for the COVID implementations, they came up with their own interpretations and with their own applications to support the similar use case. Now, what this helps is, this kind of helps us to kind of evaluate new innovations which are happening in different parts of the DHS to using countries through their respective his groups. And it kind of gives us an opportunity to see what all his groups are doing in terms of new innovations and how these innovations can be taken up in the core platform as a core feature. So a lot of the ideas came through when these apps were getting evaluated. And now these functionalities have been added as part of the DHS development roadmap, which will come through the default release cycle, and they will be part of the core functionalities. So these web apps will no longer be needed. The default functions would cover the required functionalities, which were the founding principles of these applications. This is an example of a COVID dashboard app where in Lao, there were specific requirements from the ministry to show a custom dashboard app based on the requirements which they give. So this is kind of showing you the outputs in a different format than a DHIS2 dashboard. And so a custom dashboard app can also, were also seen in many cases where custom outputs or dashboards were developed, where the source was the DHIS2 data, but the interface and the final design were different, which were kind of based on the needs shared by the ministries of health and different countries. So this was my last slide. What we'll do now is have a look at a couple of these applications, and you could also log into the respective demo instances and evaluate them. So I'll just switch my screens to the system, and then I'll take you to one of the applications, and then you could spend some time on using the same applications. Just give me a second. All right. So the first app that we're going to review is the HealthPass application, which was developed based on the requirements which we received from the Ministries of Health in the Western Central Africa region. So they wanted to generate a health pass for an individual, which could show them the history of vaccines, which had been already given to you. So as and when on the borders or on the respective areas, wherever the person required to show some authenticated proof of the vaccinations that you have taken. So they were kind of needed to show this health card to gain access or gain entry to a respective location for entry or whatever purpose. So this app was developed, which kind of, you see, they had a fixed format for the health pass. So they had these various data points which were getting captured as part of the DHIS2 COVID vaccination program. So the mechanism was that in order to generate a health pass and provide it to the individual, the health worker, the clinician was supposed to enter the ID number of that respective individual and then click on the search button. So based on the ID number, the information would get pre-filled into this form, and the QR code would also get populated, which will have basic information for this respective individual in terms of when was the first dose given, what was the vaccine which was given, batch number, expiry date, and where the vaccination was given. So there's also a print feature which could allow you to generate a PDF or print this health card or health pass for the person to use this as a document as a proof of vaccination. So by default, an output like this could not be produced from the core functionalities. It needed extensions, either as a web app, a new web app, or as an extension of the existing travel capture app. Okay? So based on the capabilities which each of the HIS group had, in order to meet these requirements, they either extended the default Tracker Capture app, the example which we saw in Vanuatu, or they built custom applications which were then plugged on the DHIS2 instance and they were used to generate outputs from them. So the demo instance that we're using, links.hispinder.org/demo1, you could log in into that specific instance now. You'll see an application called Health Pass, or it would be by its French name, because this application was developed for Francophone countries. So the default application will be available in French, but you can translate the Google page, through your Google Chrome browser. So it will give you the default in French, but you can always translate to English. The browser will give you a prompt for translation. So let's take 5 minutes to review this application, and then we can move ahead with the contact and relationship tracing. All right, so there are a couple of things. One was, I have pasted an ID in the chat box, which you can use to search the beneficiary in the Health Pass application to generate the COVID vaccine certificate for the Health Pass. Then I have pasted a link in the chat box on Zoom. You can refer this link for the next app that we're going to demonstrate. So we'll be seeing the relationship tracing app, which has been configured on the second link, which I've just pasted on the Zoom chat box. So please open that. When you open that on the landing page, there is a username and password given there. So please log in using that specific username and password. All right. So I've logged in on my demo_COVID instance, where we'll see the next example of the relationship tracing app. So once you log in using the username and password which is given on the landing page, we'll see an application called relationship tracing in the Maps app. So you can just search for that. Once you click on this app icon, there are some saved visualizations available. So a visualization of index case and contacts is already made. So we'll see how to edit this and see the data, but you can always add new visualization as well. So if you click on the index case and contacts visualization, you'll be asked to enter the enrollment start date and the end date. So in this database, we have data available for a fixed duration. So I'll put my start date as 16th of March 2020 and my end date as 18th of March 2020. So you guys can also follow the same dates. So once you put these dates in update, it will start downloading data from your tracker programs, and it will generate a map, a relationship map between the index cases and the contacts. Okay. So now, based on the data that was added for this particular duration in both the COVID case surveillance program and the contact tracing programs from 16th March to 18th March of 2020, and the relationship which was made between the index cases and the contacts, this diagram got generated, which shows you that there were 37 cases which were enrolled during the period of these 3 days. And there were 38 contacts which were associated and enrolled during the duration of these 3 days. Okay? Now, if you click on the larger light blue icon, that is your case, and the purple icons, the smaller ones, are your contacts, and the lines are the linkages between the various contacts. So the greater the number of contacts a person has, the larger is the circle for the index case. So if you see, if the person had a single contact, then you have a smaller radius. But in case you have 3 or 4 contacts, then the radius of the circle goes higher. Now, if you want to have a look at the index case, you can click on the bigger circle, the light blue one, which is for cases, and it will show you the data for the program in which this person is enrolled, the details for this respective person. And if you want to see any more information for this person, you can open the record and tracker capture directly from here. So it will redirect you to Ryan's dashboard on tracker capture in case you want to have any further look at the respective person's information. Okay. Similarly, you can do for the contacts. If you click on the contact icon, you'll have the enrolled programs as COVID-19 contact registration and follow-up, the details of the contact, and you can again open the record for this respective individual as well. Okay. So you can either edit this visualization as I did, I updated my enrollment dates, or you can delete this one if this is no longer needed. So this is also an example of a very simple relationship tracing app, which could give you a diagram of connections between the index cases which were identified during this enrollment period and the contacts which are associated during this respective period. So you can always have a look at the relationships. So these are the basic steps in which you can configure visualizations on the relationship tracing app. You need to give a name to your visualization. You need to select a relationship which you want to use for creating these visualizations. So the default relationship that we used for the COVID case surveillance and contact registration follow-up was has been in contact with. Then you can define templates for the relationship entities, the cases and the contacts, and give these icons colors accordingly. Then you can map these templates to the relationship. So the idea is that from where the relationship originates and where it ends. So the relationship was initiated from the case to the contacts. So you map from and to so that the lines could be framed accordingly. And where in kind of to make the information more clearer, the instances which do not have any relationships, those enrollments will be avoided if you select those. And if you want to use bidirectional arrows, then you can use that as well. So the diagram that we saw is only showing us the instances which have relationships. So in this period, if 50 cases were enrolled, but remaining 13 did not have any relationships, so those entities were ignored from this map, because we were focused on those entities which had relationships. Or you can always also plot the relationship, the index cases which do not have any relationships, in case you want to cross-check that whether contact tracing activity was done for these people. Okay. So this was a quick demonstration of the relationship tracing app. I've given the details on the chat. Please log in and have a look for data. Please use the dates 16th March 2020 to 18th March 2020. If there are any questions, I'll just review the chat box and answer them simultaneously. In case you're not able to log in into the demo covert instance, please let us know. We will support you accordingly. Hello everyone. So I think this was the only session we have today, so we have done that. Next we'll have the exam. So we'll start the exam in 15 minutes time at 1 p.m. IST. So you guys should be able to access the exam and start performing it. It would be a time-bound exercise, so please ensure you finish the exam within the hours allocated. The structure and the overview of the exam style is given on Moodle. Please refer that. And in case you want to use any material during the exam, so please feel free to do so. And if there are any questions or challenges, then please do let us know. We'll support you. So we'll start in 15 minutes time, and you should be able to log in into Moodle and start your attempt with examination. Thank you.